just in the process of stripping out the Land Rover's interior, taking all of about 10 minutes to remove the seats and so on. Got a sound deadening kit to fit over the next few days. It's a heavy polyurethane mat. Bit of cutting involved to fit it. There's that bulkhead section, there's a floor and footwell section, and there's a seat box section. And they come as blanks, complete mouldings, so they'll need cutting to suit this particular vehicle. So things like the handbrake gator need to be cut out, the overdrive lever, all the seat box mounts, that kind of thing. So the best way to make it effective in terms of sound deadening is not to cut it more than you need. So what I've got to do is remove all these seat tracks, the driver's seat base, and I'm going to make some spacers to lift all of these up. The mat's about 1/2 inch thick, so we'll measure that and make the spacers to suit. Not a 5 minute job, but it should make a big difference to the noise levels. So the first part of fitting is to cut out the hole for the handbrake gator. So I've got this handbrake lock thing, which I use to make some better marks. There are witness marks on the moulding, but it wasn't actually in line, so I just got a engineer's square out and made sure it was perfectly aligned. Cut around it, that's proved fine. So as you can see, the seat box section comes in one piece. What I've done is just pull it forwards and mark approximately where the seat box lids go. I need access to all three. I don't have to have the one under the driver's seat, but it's quite useful now and again. So we'll cut them all out so that a piece can be removed. So you note that my marks approximately correspond with these witness marks you may or may not see on camera, but they're for the seat box lids, so my marks are near enough that I'm happy to use those. I'll get the seat box lids and cut around them. But as you can see, quite heavy material, should be quite effective. Right, now because most of this is going to be covered, what I've done is using the witness marks in the moulding, I've put a very small pilot drill through, which is just giving me a little witness mark on the top. Most of this will be covered, so you won't see any of that, but as you can see, the marks provided are a little bit out. There is some adjustment required. It's worth double checking. So last night I made up some spacers for the seat rails. They're about the same thickness as the mat, 8 millimeters. So the idea is that the seat rails bolt down firmly on top, but without pinching the mat. Anywhere it pinches, that would spread it and you'd end up with a bad fit after all that cutting. Equally, this isn't sitting too high on the mat, so it's supported by it as well. It's a very dense material, but it means the mat can move around when fitting, say the toolbox lids, that kind of thing. So I'm just using a old cutter to cut the mat out where the spacers are going. So far so good. nearly ready to fit the driver's side seat now. I found quite a bit of trimming's been necessary. The seat box cover is slightly wider than actually necessary. So having cut these panels out last night, I've had to cut probably another 5mm off the middle and driver's side inspection cover. But it's now right up where it needs to be. I would say there is actually room if you wanted to get another layer of sound insulation under there, something like 5mm foam. There'd probably be room to do that all over the seat box. Anyway, so you can see the extra spaces I've made. I went in the workshop, made about another dozen. If there's any interest in these, I'd be quite happy to make some for people to buy, so let me know. But they give the seat mounts a nice sturdy fixing. I finished the seat box this morning. Obviously this will sit down when the rest is installed, but the handbrake gaiter and handbrake lock bracket is installed. Don't know what it's made of, but it was very tough to drill. I put it in with some more heavy duty bolts this time. Anyway, the gaiter should stop one of the last few drafts that we haven't yet blocked up. Anyway, so the seat box section's all cut. I'm leaving the panels out for now, prior to final cleaning up. I've just dropped the bulkhead section into place. Refitted the cigarette lighter socket thing. That's going to be removed and changed at some point, but might as well keep it for now. I've got to find a couple more screws for that plate. And as you can see, the battery oscillator just poking through there. Got a 20mm hole for that. So the next part of the job now, I'm just going to check up all these screws before I cover it all up. And then we're going to remove the red and yellow knobs and release the gaiter on the hollow range louver. I think then we're ready to drop in the floor section. Just dry it all up a bit first as well. Well, the job's going pretty well. Some hours have gone into this now, but we'll get in there. I'll trim the edges so the door's shut. Everything's sat down quite nicely. It's a reasonable fit. I'm sure that'll relax in the end. That's where it was in the box. I made a bit of a mess of drilling the hole for the overdrive. It's not too bad, but I'm not very happy with it. I'll show you that in a minute. My battery isolator was in just the wrong place, so I had to cut around that, but that's all right now. What I'm doing is, I mean, I've just checked the gearbox oils and that while I can get to it, but what I'm doing here is I've got the transmission access panel and I'm just sticking some supposedly sand absorbing foam to the back of it. Got a big roll of this stuff to do the roof with, so should just help a bit. But it's right over the overdrive, so I figured that it would just help cut down the noise a bit more, but also stop the panel rattling. And then we've got this to go over the top as well. So the toolbox is done out in foam inside, just to reduce the rattles and panel vibration. Thank you. I can already hear the difference in the front just with it ticking over. You can hear the roof starting to vibrate. Put my hand on it, it stops a bit. But yeah, noticeably quieter. The other thing I've checked is to see that I can engage gears without crunching, because the floor mat is quite thick, so clutch pedal down, reverse is the best test. In without any crunching. So I'm quite happy with that.